So all you have to do is to simply create an awesome design and export it with the technique I've just explained. Today we're going to learn how to make satisfying seamless carousels for Instagram using Photoshop. Also, at the end of the video, I'll be showing you how you can download not one, not five, but 10 seamless Instagram templates that I'm about to dissect so that you can use them indefinitely and take your Instagram game to the next level. So if you're ready to learn some cool Photoshop tricks, then grab your snacks, get comfortable, and let's get cracking. This video is brought to you by the official François Fourmis store. Edit your pictures like a pro with one tap using my custom Lightroom presets. You can now get 5% off your first order with the coupon code François5 by following the link in the video description. What's up everybody, my name is François, thanks so much for joining me on this beautiful day. So I'm sure you've already seen these posts on Instagram, they're very popular and very satisfying to see. You're on the first picture of a carousel, you slide to see the second one, and wow, it's seamless! What? Now, if you're already posting content like this, it's likely that you're creating some long file on Canva. Then you have to pull up your phone, get distracted on TikTok for 45 minutes. Then you open Canva to download the design you've just made. You download it onto your phone. But now you've got to run this long JPEG file into a third-party dodgy app that's filled with ads to slice it into squares that have been compressed to heck to post it on Instagram, who is also going to compress your content to heck. This has to be changed today. What if you could do all this hard work with just one software that you're already familiar with, which allows you to turn one long document into a series of squares or vertical images with one simple keyboard shortcut? Well, this day has come, my friend. After watching this video, you'll be able to do just that and streamline your workflow for all future posts. So let's get into it. So let's say that you want to create 5 square slides in your carousel. In this case, you're going to create a new document with these dimensions, 5,400 pixel width and 1,080 pixel height. Now, before you can drop anything in this document, you need to know where the seams are going to be. That is where the picture's edges are. The point of doing a seamless carousel is to give the illusion that there are literally no cuts between each slide. Breaking up these edges will massively improve your followers' experience when they scroll through the carousel. So for that, we're going to use the ruler and a few guides. Bring up the ruler by simply pressing Ctrl or Command R on your keyboard. This will add a horizontal ruler at the top and a vertical ruler on the side. Next, we're going to right-click on either of these two rulers and make sure that the unit is set to pixels. Now we're going to add vertical guides that will show us exactly where the seams are. For that, simply click on the left ruler and drag it onto your document. The blue line is called a guide and will not appear on the final renders. Also, if you need to, you can toggle them on and off by pressing Ctrl or Command semicolon on your keyboard. Now, I've randomly placed this ruler here, but really, I need one to be placed every 1080 pixels. So I'm just going to click on it again and drag it until the x-axis says 1080 pixels. In order to make the guide snap to round values, I'm going to hold down Shift on my keyboard. Okay, so that's in place. Let's now repeat this process 3 more times at 2160 pixels, at 3240 pixels, and at 4320 pixels. Okay, that's done. Now, this is the guide for the first slide, this is the guide for the second slide, and so on and so forth. So let's say that I'm going to make a carousel about, how to smash the like button for the algorithm. Okay, so I'm not going to create a carousel from scratch, but basically the main thing I always focus on is first a background that covers all the 5 slides, and then I always add some decorative elements. Ideally, I like it when all those elements cross over from one slide to another. Okay, so now we've got our cool design. The limits are set for Instagram, this is cool. However, this is still not enough for Photoshop to know how to export the slides separately. Also, Instagram won't allow you to post such a wide picture at once. So why did we bother creating such a wide document in Photoshop? What's the point of bothering with all this? Well, don't worry, it will all make sense after this next step. Now we can use this information to tell Photoshop where to cut our pictures. Before anything, let's go up to View and make sure that Snap is toggled on. Now let's go over to the Crop tool. I know, it's probably not the tool you were expecting. Now click and hold onto the Crop tool until this drop-down menu appears, and select the Slice tool. Now what we're able to do is simply click and drag on our document to create 5 different slices, and these slices will snap with the guides we've placed earlier. So click and drag until you end up with 5 slices. You should see the numbers 1 through 5 appear on the top left corners of each one. And now, the moment you've been curious about this whole time, how the heck is that going to help us slice this long image? Go up to File, then go to Export and select Save for Web Legacy. Alternatively, you can also use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl or Command Alt plus Shift plus S. This menu has a lot of options, but really, the ones you need to check are simple. Make sure that the format is set to JPEG, the quality is set to 100%, and press save. Now the name you enter here will be followed by a series of numbers in the order in which you created the slices. I'm just going to call this tutorial. Now, very important, make sure that these options say image only, default settings, and all slices. Now you guessed it, this is where Photoshop does all the cutting. Let's check this out. It's created an entirely new folder and all our slices are here. It's a very unknown function in Photoshop, but now you can replicate this as many times as you wish. I know it's a bit of a laborious process, but like I said in the intro, if you want to download not one, not two, not five, but 10 Instagram carousel templates, check out the first link in the video description. I've literally just released a new pack of them. They're already rigged, they already have their markers on, they're already sliced, so all you have to do is to simply create an awesome design and export it with the technique I've just explained. Control, Command, Shift, Alt, and S, and that's it. This will save you a ton of time and make your workflow so much faster. So make sure you download my new pack and let me know how you get on in the comments. So there you have it, this is how to actually create seamless Instagram carousels using Photoshop. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something useful. If you did and you didn't like my accent, you can like this video as it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. Also, feel free to get subscribed and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos. As I said, if you want to save a tremendous amount of time and streamline your workflow, check out the first link in the description to download these amazing 10 Instagram carousel templates. You'll thank me later. As always, if you're wondering what to watch next, I recommend you to watch this video right here. Thanks again for watching. My name is Francois. See you in the next video.